If you are looking to detailed welds in SolidWorks, there are two options: Weld Bead and Fillet Bead. Both allow us to define welds in a 3D model, however the outcome of these tools are very different. The Weld Bead feature creates a graphical representation of a weld in a part or assembly environment. Similar to cosmetic threads, Weld Beads give us visual confirmation of the weld's relative size and position without creating a solid body. This requires little resources from your PC and has little impact on the performance. The Weld Bead command makes it easy to define the weld geometry by selecting edges or intersecting faces to define its location. Weld Beads support options such as tangent propagation, both sides, all around, and intermittent welds. Welds are grouped by size and type in dedicated folder at the top of the feature tree. Within the folder, we can assign the types of weld, material, costs, and time taken to produce. This can all be displayed in a drawing using a weld table. Fillet Bead tool creates solid bodies in a part rather than just a graphical representation. To produce a fillet weld, we must have adjoining faces from at least two bodies for selection. This allows us to check clearances involving the welds, which may cause issues further downstream, as well as add material properties and analyse them as part of an FEA study. Solid bodies produced with fillet beads can also have appearances applied to them. This gives us an accurate representation of the end product, and so they lend themselves well to projects where photorealistic renders may be required. Unlike weld beads, fillet beads cannot be added at the assembly level, only within a multi-body part. Fillet beads do not populate in the weld folder as seen with weld beads. What tool you use ultimately comes down to what you plan to do with your model next. If weld properties, callouts, and documentation are a priority, use weld bead. If a physical weld is required for FEA or visuals, then fillet bead is the tool for you.